Alright guys, this is part 5. Wow, making a lot of videos on this. But yeah, part 5 and me talking about some of my favorite characters in video games. And we're staying with the same franchise as we stuck with since the past videos. Metal Gear Solid, the first game this time. I talked about a male character in talking about Metal Gear Solid 2, so this video is going to be a female character. I can't quite explain why, but I really, really felt attached to this character. Sniper Wolf. It's so weird, because, like I said in talking about Metal Gear Solid, Otacon is a character that I relate to the most. Wow, that was such an Asian thing to do. I relate to most. But at the same time, when I think of Metal Gear Solid, like, the first character that pops in my mind is Sniper Wolf. And that's why, like, I wanted Otacon to be my favorite character from the entire Metal Gear Solid franchise. But then I thought of the first game. I'm just like, well, actually, no. I like Sniper Wolf the most. And then I thought about the third game. It's just like, the boss. She's my favorite character from MGS3. So, I'm having that since I gotta have to do videos on each of these games and not as a franchise as a whole. Sniper Wolf is my favorite character. Maybe it's the accent. I love her accent. But then again, I still like her in Twin Snakes. She has a weaker accent, and I think it's worse. The voice acting, I think, is worse because she has a weaker accent. But I think her accent is really cool. Her backstory is definitely really cool. Maybe it's nostalgia goggles. Metal Gear Solid was one of the first games I've ever played, you know, story-driven wise. It's one of the very first story-driven games I've ever played. I was a teenager when I first played it. I was like 14 or 13, I don't remember. Or maybe older. I don't quite remember. But yeah, it's just like, wow, this is a character who really just went, like, her background really touched me, you know. She makes a very short, she doesn't make too much of an appearance in the game. Her monologues are really short in the entire game. She appears a couple of times, but not much, you know. She's definitely not an important, like, the question, who is the most important character in the game? Sniper Wolf wouldn't even come close to that answer, you know. She's definitely not an important character in the game. She's nowhere near being an important character in the game. But I don't think it matters to me, because I'm drawn to her. I'm drawn to her story, and her request at the end is one of the most thing that the moving thing in the entire game to me. When the, you know, give me my gun, and then Snake knows what he has to do, and does it and puts the handkerchief over her face. It's a powerful moment. To me, that moment for me was the most striking moment in that game, and that game had a lot of shocking moments to me. It's not a shocking moment, but it was a moving moment. It was the moment that made me pause. After that cutscene, I held my controller. I was just kind of just taking it in. I'm just like, wow, okay, that just happened. And then you hear the owl, the wolf, woo, you know, just moaning her death. And you feel it. And you're inside this desolate place. You're in the middle of gigantic snowland, you know, and it's cornered, it's walled off with these metallic doors, and the atmosphere of that, of her death, and then you just being there, and then the wolf owling, there's no music, just owling. It's a very moving moment to me. It's one of the most powerful moments in the game to me, and maybe that's why I grew so attached to Sniper Wolf. Compared to other characters, Metal Gear Solid 1 has a really strong cast of characters, especially in that era. Like voice acting wise, in that era, 1998, what other, like, so many other games, like, I feel like, I don't know, maybe I'm biased, I have my Metal Gear Solid fanboy goggles on, but what other game has such a cast of characters who are just so so real feeling, you know, and interesting and unique, and down to earth in that manner. Some are crazy, pretty crazy, but Ocelot was an awesome character. Liquid Snake, with his, you know, obsessiveness about him, this inferiority complex that he has, was pretty interesting to kind of battle against him. Solid Snake's continued manipulation, maybe, like, I can't, you know, there it's just such a strong cast of characters. No characters in Metal Gear Solid, like, really bothered me all that much. Gray Fox is here. He's pretty legendary status in the MGS fan base now. And in the original Metal Gear Solid, not Twin Snakes, you know, the voice actor for Gray Fox also voiced DARPA Chief. And that was really cool. Yeah, and turns out to be, I guess, the one character that we really never meet, but is still really interesting is, well, we actually do meet him, but Decoy Octopus is pretty awesome. Just the fact that he tricked you like that, even though the game hints you a lot of times. Psycho Mantis, Vulcan Raven, all the villains of MGS1 were, I think these were the strongest cast of villains. And that's why I feel like Kojima has tried again and again to replicate the cast of villains, or the Foxhound unit. You know, MGS2 is pretty much like, you know, S3 is wrongly interpreted, but interpreted in one way as Solid Snake Simulation. That's not the real S3, but, you know, the replication of the Foxhound unit that Snake fought against is MGS2. MGS3 is kind of similar, but they're all flat and one-dimensional. Beauty and the Beast is like Kojima trying to one-up, you know, all the names of the Beauty and the Beast are taken right from the Foxhound unit from MGS1. But the personality traits of MGS1's Foxhound unit is just so awesome. I really could not ask for a better cast of villains to fight against. And they were really cool. This is the one game where the villains really are just awesome, interesting characters. Including Otacon, including Ocelot, and Liquid Snake. There's not a single character in Metal Gear Solid that I am bothered by and am annoyed by, and I always find those in many other Metal Gear Solid games as well. Like, Metal Gear Solid 4, not annoyed by, but, well, Rosemary was annoying, of course. Not annoyed by, but, like, you know, the Beauty and the Beast unit was not much of a thing. Metal Gear Solid 3, you know, just, Eva was a bit annoying. And, you know, it's just the cast of characters in MGS1, I think, are all consistently awesome. So that's one thing. That's why it's easy for me to just pick Sniper Wolf out of the bunch. Just be like, okay, all the characters are great, but that's the one I like the most. So that's why I feel like, you know, I can ask the question, who was your favorite character from Metal Gear Solid 1? And a lot of people I'm going to talk to, most of them are going to have totally different answers. Some are going to say Psycho Mantis. Some would say Liquid Snake. Some would say Gray Fox. You know? There's definitely a lot of characters to choose from in Metal Gear Solid 1. Mine is Sniper Wolf. What is yours? So with that, I will end this video. Next video, since this was a female character that I talked about, it will be a male character, of course.